We'll link her site down in this.
你是收音机吗
？Whoa! What are you doing?
March 17th is coming.
Oh, are we reading a book about St. Patrick's Day?
Bingo! Today we'll be reading about a story of St. Patrick, written by Sunny. Sunny is a bilingual educator who set out to make Chinese and English bilingual parenting and learning fun and doable.
We'll link her site down in the description box where you can download the book for free. Go get a copy and come read with us.
Like, subscribe, and come join our community on Instagram. A lot of fun stuff out there.
Let's go! 在很久很久以前，有一位叫派翠克的小男孩在英国出生。在他16岁的那一年，派翠克被一群海盗绑架到爱尔兰当奴隶。
到了那里，派翠克发现爱尔兰人讲的语言、住的房子和生活习惯都跟在英国的时候很不一样。
有什么不一样呢？
这个吗？
这个问题就由我圣派翠克专家来告诉你们吧。当时爱尔兰信的是像太阳、树木这样的自然物体，而派翠克家信的是基督教，信的是耶稣基督。这样你们明白了吧？
是这样。在他当奴隶的时候，他很辛苦又孤单，还要困难的去适应新的环境。
那时候派翠克开始想起在他小时候认识的神。在爱尔兰的6年内，每次他在帮他爱尔兰的首领牧羊的时候，他就常常在祷告中跟神说他的痛苦。慢慢的，耶稣成为他最要好的朋友。
有一天晚上，上帝透过梦跟派翠克说，离开奴隶的生活的时间到了，有一艘船预备好带你回家。派翠克在神的带领下顺利地回到英国，终于看见了他6年内不停想念的家人。
回到英国后，派翠克开始努力学习圣经，因为他想要更认识那位当他在爱尔兰帮助他平安度过6年的耶稣基督。他找了一位老师教导他。
差不多20年后，神又透过一场梦告诉派翠克回去爱尔兰，跟那些之前虐待他的人分享耶稣永远不会放弃爱我们的好消息。这次回去，他不是以一个奴隶的身份，而是带着足以释放人心、充满大能的福音。
派翠克在神的带领下，他用当时他在爱尔兰的经历，慢慢地让爱尔兰人体会到神的慈爱和认识到神的真理。
哇哦，那他是怎么说服爱尔兰人的呢？
这个嘛，
到了我出场的时间了。派翠克用的是这个三叶草，三叶草在爱尔兰到处都是。派翠克用这个来解释上帝的三位一体 ：The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit， 圣父、圣子和圣灵。当时更传说，派翠克赶走了爱尔兰岛上所有的蛇呢。这样你们明白了没有？
他在那里建了许多教会，带领神所爱的儿女回到神的怀里。
我们的神真是位奇妙的神，他透过派翠克的痛苦经历，把这些在人看来不好的经历变成爱尔兰人的祝福，以及派翠克的最大的冒险。信实的神也会把我们的泪水变成喜乐的祝福。
Long ago, there was a boy named Patrick who was born in England. When he was 16, He was kidnapped by some Irish pirates and sold off as a slave.
When he arrived in Ireland, he discovered that not only their language different from his, but also their houses and their way of life. It was really hard being a slave. He often felt alone and struggled in his new environment.
During that time, Patrick started to get to know the God of his childhood. During his 6 years in Ireland, when he was shepherding his master, a chief of Ireland's sheep, he would take those times to pray. He would share his difficulties with Jesus, who slowly became his closest friend.
One night, God spoke to Patrick through a dream. It's time for you to leave your life as a slave. There is a ship that's ready to take you home. God led Patrick safely home, back to England, where he was finally able to see his family he's been missing for the last 6 years.
Once he returned to England, Patrick began to learn more about the Bible. He wanted to get to know the words of Jesus, the God that helped him through those 6 long years in Ireland. He found a teacher to teach him.
About 20 years later, God gave Patrick another dream. This time, God tells Patrick to return to Ireland to share the good news of Jesus Christ's never-ending love. This time, Patrick was not going as a slave, but as a child of God, bringing the power of the gospel that can set hearts free.
Under God's leadership, using what he learned through his time there, Patrick slowly helped the people of Ireland encounter Jesus' goodness and his truth. He established many churches there, leading many of God's sons and daughters back into his embrace.
We have an amazing God. He took the difficulties Patrick experienced during his time in Ireland and turned them into a blessing for the people of Ireland and Patrick's greatest adventure. Our faithful God can also turn our tears into joy.